the video game news has been going overtime lately, and there are definitely three stories that I want to talk about in today's video that I think are pretty exciting. First off, it looks like we're getting yet another Mega Man compilation coming out in early 2020, and a lot of people are excited for this, and I'm looking forward to this compilation as well. Mario Kart Tour finally has a release date. We have a trailer for the game, and I definitely want to look at the trailer and talk about what to expect from Mario Kart Tour for your mobile device. And of course, the Nintendo rumor mill is heating up when it comes to a Nintendo Direct. Yesterday, there was sort of an unveiling, a sort of leak about a potential Nintendo Switch game coming to the system, and I definitely think this ties in to a Nintendo Direct and maybe even some Smash Brothers implications as well. All that, plus we got a box of retro game treasure to check out in this video, so it's gonna be a packed video. So sit back, relax, make sure you subscribe to the channel, and let's talk about what's going on in the world of video games.
Hey, RGT85. Hey, Sean.
Oh my God, it's Stevie Richards! So first off, when it comes to older companies, I love to see compilations. And of course, Capcom has been pretty much at the forefront of that recently. We've had things like the Mega Man Legacy Collection. We had the Mega Man X Legacy Collection. We had some great Street Fighter compilations as well. Capcom has been doing a really good job when it comes to revisiting their old IPs and bringing them to modern platforms. So I definitely respect that. Well, now another fan favorite in the Mega Man franchise looks like it's going to be getting a release in early 2020. And that is the Mega Man ZX Collection. Now this was leaked yesterday on the PS4 storefront, digital storefront. For some reason, they put it up there and now it seems like it's disappeared. But yes, it looks like the Mega Man ZX Legacy Collection will be coming out in early 2020. Now, Mega Man ZX games admittedly aren't a franchise that I'm super familiar with. I remember playing the first one on the Nintendo DS, but I never really played any beyond that. But it seems like it's a very well-received franchise. And one of the reasons why is because it's done by Inti Creates. Now, Inti Creates nowadays is a household name, but back during that time, nobody really knew what Inti Creates was all about. So I'm definitely looking forward to visiting these games again, especially the first game, because that will probably be the one I remember, considering I never really played the others. This is more of a Metroidvania style Mega Man game though. There's different missions, there's different upgrades you can get, and you kind of have a bit of a free roam aspect to it as well. So it's great to see these companies revisiting and doing these compilations for their older games. It really sort of brings these games to a newer generation of gamers, and I think it's a very positive thing. It'll probably be released on the PS4, Xbox One, and Nintendo Switch along with Steam in early 2020, and I definitely think it's something to be excited about. I love Inti Creates games, so I'm definitely looking forward to going into their back catalog of Mega Man games as well. So Mega Man ZX should be out early 2020. Let me know what you think about this in the comments section down below. Next up, we finally have a release date for the new Mario Kart game, Mario Kart Tour for your iOS or Android device. This game will be available on September 25th. Now, of course, they did an open beta for this game on Android devices. I signed up for the beta, I was accepted into the beta, and then I never heard anything else from them, so I never got to check this game out. But one of the details about the embargo for the beta was you couldn't have any screenshots and you couldn't have any video of the game actually running. So I was definitely interested to see what sort of graphical style this game would use and how the game would actually look. But now we have a trailer for the game, and honestly, I think the trailer looks pretty decent. Now, obviously, it's not going to be something as great as Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, but for a free-to-start mobile game, I think it looks pretty solid. One thing I really like about the graphical style of the game is how they're using, like, real-world locations. You can see the Eiffel Tower in one of the levels, so it looks like they're going to, with the tour thing, sort of like a world tour in different real-world locales, and that's not something you've seen in a Mario Kart game before. One thing that's really interesting, though, is the inclusion of Diddy Kong in this game. We haven't seen Diddy Kong in a racing game since Diddy Kong Racing. It was last released on the Nintendo DS, and Diddy Kong Racing is something that a lot of people want remastered or revisited or even get a sequel on modern platforms because it had sort of a bit of an open world aspect to the game as well, and there was a lot of different things you could do in that game that made the racing really fun. Although one thing I have to say is nobody ever talks about how bad the voices were in Diddy Kong Racing, and I don't know why, because they were horrible. I'm Banjo.
I'm Conker. Timba!
Like, these voices were terrible and nobody ever talks about them. Sure, it was a small aspect of the game, but when you're choosing your character and having you hear these weird voices, like, I don't know, it just really grinded my gears, to be honest with you. But I think Mario Kart Tour has a chance of being a decent kart racer for mobile devices. Now, of course, you gotta worry about one thing, and that is microtransactions. Because this is a free-to-start mobile game, there's obviously going to be microtransactions at the ass. Now, is this going to extend into characters and levels and things like that? That will remain to to be seen. Nintendo's been pretty quiet about it. It could just be cosmetic stuff, but knowing how the mobile marketplace works, I wouldn't hold my breath on it just being simply cosmetics. All in all though, it is a free to start game, so you might as well download it and check it out and see what it's all about, and maybe you'll have some fun with it. I know I'll be checking it out when it drops on September 25th. I'll probably do a little pseudo review, maybe an impressions video on what the game is all about. And yeah, maybe it'll be decent, maybe it won't be, but I do like the graphical style of the game. Next up, we have a box of Retro Game Treasure to check out. If you're unfamiliar with Retro Game Treasure, it is a monthly subscription service where they send you 3 to 5 games every month in the retro game variety. You sign up on their website, you choose what systems you want to collect for, you tell them what games you already have, and they do their best to not send you duplicates. They also update their inventory after sending you games, which I think is really cool, and it's a decent little service. You know, they don't pay me to talk about them. They do send me a free box every month to check out though, and I mean, it's free retro games, so I absolutely love it. But yeah, definitely a cool little service. There's a link in the description box down below if you want to sign up and save a little bit of money. No kickback for me, but they do send me a box every month to check out. Without any further ado though, let's see what games I got. Stare into your soul as I open the box. First off, we have a Sega Genesis game that I don't own, and that is Super Hang-On. Now, of course, this is an arcade-based racing game where you're on a motorcycle. The box has seen better days, you know, the plastic has seen better days, but let's see, it is complete in box, so that's cool, and there goes the game, and I don't own this game, so now I own this game, so that's pretty cool. I probably will swap out this box, though. I'm pretty sure I have some extra Sega Genesis boxes around here somewhere, but yeah, Super Hang-On, that's a cool game, and I'm glad to have it in the collection. Next up, we have a GameCube game. What could it be? Oh God! Oh God! Shadow the Hedgehog. Now, if you missed my ranking the Sonic the Hedgehog games video from Sunday, make sure you guys check it out because I go pretty in-depth on Shadow the Hedgehog and talk about this game. But yeah, it's the infamous Shadow the Hedgehog. I don't think I have it on the GameCube. I'm pretty sure I own it on the PS2, so it's nice to have this on the GameCube. But yeah, it's Shadow the Hedgehog, like, ugh. And the final game in this box, Dreamcast. Ooh, Carrier. Now this is actually a really cool sort of old school style survival horror game. This is actually kind of a pricey game. I want to say it goes for like $25. It is obviously missing the manual, but you know, it does have the case and the disc itself. Let's check a look at the disc. The disc is very minty clean. You know, there's no scratches on it. But yeah, Carrier is actually a super decent game, a sort of a forgotten about survival horror game. If you like old school survival horror games, it's definitely worth checking out. I don't think I ever finished it. I'm pretty sure I do own it on the Dreamcast already, but you know, good trade fodder to have as well. So yeah, a decent little box. Carrier's obviously probably the crown jewel of this. You got Super Hang-On from the Sega Genesis, and then you have this. And finally, yesterday, a big Nintendo Switch game was potentially leaked by Amazon because I guess people are just impatient and they don't know how to work Amazon properly. But a listing for a Nintendo Switch case went up on Amazon yesterday for a specific game. And when you look at this case for the Nintendo Switch, you would say that that game's not on the Nintendo Switch and this is an officially licensed product. And that game is, of course, Overwatch. Everyone has been talking about Overwatch now coming to the Nintendo Switch. And while I'm not a huge Overwatch fan, I do think it is a good fit for the Nintendo Switch. You've seen games like Paladins do really well on the Switch. Obviously, Overwatch is a huge game. There are all sorts of like esports tournaments for it. There's a ton of money into it as well. But yeah, they leaked this case as coming to the Nintendo Switch. It's clearly an Overwatch case. It has all the Overwatch branding on it. So more than likely, we're getting an announcement very soon of Overwatch coming to the Nintendo Switch. But I think there's bigger implications when it comes to Nintendo Direct stuff with this. Last year, there were heavy rumors about Diablo 3 coming to the Nintendo Switch. And then a September Direct happened, and we learned about Diablo 3 coming to the Switch, and then it was released for the Switch. So more than likely, this is Blizzard yet again doing another announcement during a September Nintendo Direct, and this game, Overwatch, now coming to the Nintendo Switch. So I definitely think there's going to be a September Nintendo Direct. There's been a lot of rumors about it. Obviously, with the 1 year anniversary of Nintendo Switch Online, people are expecting SNES games to be added into it. I've actually heard some rumors about some things going on. There actually might be some Breath of the Wild 2 information during this Nintendo Direct presentation, but I'm 99.9% sure that there will be a Nintendo Direct in the month of September, and this is just definitely adding more fuel to the fire. Now, what's really interesting, though, is there could be Smash Brothers implications about this as well, dealing with Overwatch, because supposedly the next character that's going to be revealed for Smash Brothers is going to be a female character that really isn't tied in with any Nintendo stuff. So a lot of people are thinking now this will be Tracer, who is obviously one of the most popular characters in the Overwatch universe. I think it would have been cool if it was Trace from Metroid Prime Hunters, just because I love love Metroid Prime Hunters. But yeah, it looks like Tracer could be the next character announced for Smash Brothers. And once again, if you're doing a September Nintendo Direct, what better way to sort of drum up interest in Overwatch than by announcing Tracer as the next Smash Brothers character alongside of Overwatch coming to the Nintendo Switch? Now, would Smash Brothers fans be disappointed with Tracer being the character? I don't know. You know, it's obviously not a tied in Nintendo franchise. It's not anything that really has any sort of Nintendo lineage to it, but I do think it would be pretty cool and sort of expanding the Smash Brothers universe into additional characters, because really at the end of the day, to me, Smash Brothers is a celebration of video games, and that's why you have all these different characters in it. So it looks like Overwatch is coming to the Switch. It looks like this September Nintendo Direct is pretty much confirmed, and Tracer might end up being in Smash Brothers. All right, so those are the big stories that I wanted to talk about in today's video. So let me know in the comments section down below what you think of everything. Are you excited for the Mega Man ZX collection? Will you be checking out Mario Kart Tour? What did you think about my box of retro games? And what do you think about Overwatch coming to the Nintendo Switch? Are you pretty much confident like me that there's going to be a September Direct? And what do you think of Tracer potentially being the next character in the Smash Brothers universe? And as always, guys, thank you for checking out this video. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications. Check out other videos on the channel. And as always, I will catch you guys on the next one. Later.